content creation has becoming a lot more low lift lately with tools like Riverside. And I'm gonna show you how I have been using it lately to make my YouTube content creation processes a lot more easier so that I can create more blog posts, emails, and social media posts quicker than I used to. If you're new here, my name is Jamar Diggs. I am a YouTube strategist and I help businesses leverage YouTube to create a more low-level marketing strategy. And in this video, I'm gonna get into how I'm currently using Riverside to make my content creation so much easier. If you've ever been interested in Riverside or you've been wanting to figure out what is gonna be a solution for your YouTube content creation workflow to be a little bit more easier, you're definitely gonna wanna stick around. If you wanna take a look at things while I am showing you around my own back end, definitely go ahead and click the link in the description down below where you can go ahead and start a free trial with Riverside. And if you use my code Jamar Diggs, you'll be able to save 15% off. All right, so let's get into it. In a quick second, I'm going to do a nice little screen sharing session with you to take you behind the scenes of my very own Riverside dashboard to walk you through some of like my favorite features. Just to give you a better idea of what Riverside is, it is more of a remote recording studio where you're able to easily film content, film videos, podcasts, client interviews. You're able to easily edit them or export them and give them to your video editor, which is what I do. There's so many other features to make it so much easier, especially with them adding more and more AI tools inside this platform all the time. I'm gonna go ahead and switch over to the screen sharing so that you can kind of start seeing for yourself how Riverside can help you in your business while you are creating more low-lift visibility strategies in your business. All right, let's get into how I'm using Riverside for my YouTube content and also other forms of content creation. There's a few features that I definitely want to highlight for you. The first one is going to be this amazing studio, this remote recording studio. Now, when I used to record without Riverside or a remote or any type of remote recording studio, I would be recording with a tool called QuickTime on my computer, and then I would be recording and then I would have to download it onto my computer and upload it into Google Drive to share with my video editor. And that was also a case for my YouTube management clients. And there were so many times where I would get messages of them saying, I did my video, but it's gonna be so many hours for it to upload to Drive. And it was like they just hated it. And so having this solution here makes everything so easy. So let's get into like what the remote recording studio even looks like to begin with. You may start out with just one studio. Now these studios, I like to use them as like folders basically of like different projects that I do. And so right now we're looking at my YouTube channel one where I will record my YouTube videos. I have a section here for client interviews. If I want to get some client testimonials, we have a studio just for that. And then also guest interviews. I have a studio just for management client work. And then I also have a studio just for my YouTube membership. And then also some other like projects that I'm working on. I have decided to create another project just for that. And then also have a section just for my social media clips, like things that I record outside of Riverside that I want to like use some of these features for. I just have a little section there for it, a little studio just for it right there. And the reason why I have these sections here is because you're able to invite people to these studios. And so let's just say like if I wanted to do like some client interviews, all I would have to do is just send this little invitation link for this studio and they would have access to that to join this studio versus things just being all together and all the recordings in just one big old studio. That just makes me a little bit more anxious. So let's take a look at this studio in particular to show you how things are going to, you're going to connect all of your things, right? So I'm going to say that I'm not using headphones right now, but you're able to connect your webcam. You're able to use the microphone that you want to use and the speakers that you want to use, right? So right now I'm using my webcam, but you can connect your DSLR camera here if you want to. Like that's what I normally do whenever I'm using this this thing. Right now it's charging. Normally I have it set up right in front of me and it's connected to my computer. But using Riverside and these other features now makes me want to just kind of like stick my camera like up there so that I can easily just use this other feature, like the the script and the teleprompter feature that I'm going to show you as well. Well, join here. This is the studio, right? And so like I said before, you can invite people very easy just by using this little link here. It makes it super, super easy. We're going to exit out of here. I'm going to show you that you can also rename this recording right here. You can go over into settings and change a few things. So if you know, if you see that your camera is like shooting at 720 right now, you can move it up just by going in to, I want to say it's in recording, and you can change that to advanced, and you can have it go up to 1080p or up to 4K. My webcam, I think, does 1080p. You can also change the frame rate if you want to. Change the transcription language here, which we'll go through that in a minute. You're good to go. We'll now record in 1080p. Great for me right now. And this is the studio. Super, super easy to use. You can just literally just press record and start talking. Now, to make things even more easier, you can also use this feature here to where you can add in a script to help you throughout your recording. And you can adjust it just like how you would a regular like document, right? So if you want to like bold things, you can. If you want to make it a little bit more smaller so that your eyes aren't going too far, or you can make it bigger if you need to. Right. And you can either record and scroll and watch it, or you can use the teleprompter feature here and easily start recording and read your script just like this. Now, you can make it also big like this and then start the whole teleprompter going. And so as you speak, you can literally start reading this, making it so much easier for your eyes to be on the camera. You're able to also share your screen if you want to. I did a project the other day. It was a presentation for a summit, and I actually like presented inside of a Riverside studio, and it was so easy to do. It gave me these other tracks, right? So it gave me a version of like the full version, but then it also popped out the screen sharing file as well. You could either edit it all yourself inside with these different tracks, or you could just use the one completed track that Riverside gives you and send it off to someone. The great thing about the studio, like I said before, like I don't have to download anything onto my computer. And so what I do now is whenever I finish recording, this little page generates, and you'll see if I move myself out of the way, I have a transcript that's automatically being generated. I also have the high quality recording here where my video editor is going to be able to download onto their computer. All I have to do, press share right here, and now they have what they need to be successful. Right? I don't have to upload anything to Drive or Dropbox. I don't have to download anything. It doesn't take hours for me to get this file over to my team. It makes it so much easier. Now, when the video editor has finished editing, I'm able to use this video in another way. But let's say that you don't have a video editor. Once this whole thing is done, there's a few things that you can do. Now, with the AI transcription, you can go ahead and start editing this clip by just pressing this little scissors button. And now what you see here is the full raw footage with the transcript that you can literally just edit the whole video off of. For example, you see where I say my intro, and I said, and in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly how I help my clients, but I messed up because then I took a pause here and then I reset it. And I kind of reset it a few times, if you can see. Okay. And so if I wanted to, I could do two things. So you see all of these silences, I can go ahead and just remove all silences with this magic tools feature here, right? Which you can see right here. And so there's 271 seconds of silence. Let's just go ahead and apply that and remove all of the silences. So you immediately have the dead space removed. If I want, I can go ahead and remove all of the times I repeated that. And if you can see that, I also said, I don't like that one. So we're gonna do this one instead. Oh my gosh. But anyway, there we go. We can delete all of that. And so you see how I messed up all of that. And so now I'm able to just have my intro here and it will go to this one. So let's go ahead and look at an example. Well, let's like see how it sounds.
I'm Jamar Diggs, low-level marketing expert and YouTube strategist, and I help businesses create sustainable marketing strategies so that they can make content marketing only 10% of their CEO activity. And in this video, I'm going to let you in on how I've been able to help my clients get results like 13,000 views.
And so you see how there was a little extra pause there, right? We can go into this timeline even closer by making it a little bit more bigger. And you see there's that space there. Well, we can go bring this little head here and we can now split it and we can delete this. So now let's take a look at it. Just kidding. I almost deleted the entire first part, but now let's go back into this section here. And now we're able to just snip this other section.
And in this—
perfect. Okay. So all we need to do is just delete this whole little space here and we're going to split it again. Now we should be able to delete this. And let's see how it sounds now.
And YouTube strategist, and I help businesses create sustainable marketing strategies so that they can make content marketing only 10% of their CEO activity. And in this video, I'm going to let you in on how I've been able to help my clients get results like 13,000 views.
Perfect. Okay, great. And then when you're all done, you can just go ahead and start exporting it right here. My video editor then edited the video that I sent to them. And now we have this. So I re-uploaded this inside of here because it gives me all those things that I mentioned before. So now I have a transcript. Now I have a transcript that doesn't have all of my raw footage stuff in it. The AI features inside of Riverside creates these little show notes here, right? So, you know, show notes are mostly for like podcasting, but you know, the things that I use for YouTube is the chapters feature, right? So we all know that you can add timestamps to your YouTube videos, right? And so I love that I don't have to do that manually anymore. Now I can just take the chapters, copy them from either here or from the actual video section, go from there and use that. It also gives me magic clips too. So it takes these sections out of my video that it thinks are the most engaging pieces, and it creates these little editable clips here where I'm able to refine them if I want to, and also export them, all without me having to like lift a finger. And I'm also able to change how the layout looks. So I'll give you an example by clicking into one of these, and you see how it's already chosen some of the clips here. And so what I love is that I can choose the video ratio, right? So it started out like this, but then I changed it to fill it just like this if I wanted to use it. I can also add in some spacing, make the corners round if I would like to. Captions are also really, really great too. So I can go in and change how these captions look. Here are a few options here. I can change it to pop-ins, change the colors if I wanted to, make them larger or smaller, make them all caps or title case, the alignment. And then I'm good to go here. If I wanted to make some changes again, I can use the text-based editor to bring things back to life if I wanted to. If I wanted to restore a certain section, then I could. I could just restore that, and then now it's back into the timeline. This makes it so much easier for you to figure out like what parts of your content you want to share as little clips anywhere. Now, going back to the AI transcription feature, it's really, really cool because you are now able to take that transcript and use it in so many different ways. Now, when it comes to YouTube, I'm able to use that transcript, that polished transcript, and apply it to a YouTube video so that I can have closed captions in my YouTube videos. I'm also able to take that same transcript and use ChatGPT to create a video description for me. Along with that same transcript, I'm able to create a promotional email for my YouTube video. I'm able to find little key moments that I can use as social media posts, all like written by ChatGPT that I can then, you know, make better. That I can then like make better, make into my own voice. So much more that you can do just from your transcription. You can even use it to write a blog post. And that's really what I end up doing. Like, I end up using my transcript and having ChatGPT draft a type of blog post that I then take some of those best parts and apply it to the blog post that I end up finalizing. And so it just makes the process so much easier because you're never starting from scratch. You're always starting from the foundation of your YouTube video, and then ChatGPT is putting it in an email form or putting it in a blog form that then you can then edit to the way that you really, really want it. So I really love the AI transcriptions feature, and so much so that I use it even for our management clients too, to where we're able to use this same thing and take the transcript and also the chapters. And one of the ways that I do that is just by going to the edit section and going to this little three dots here and copying the chapters list and then just pasting it into my YouTube video description. It makes it so much easier. And also, for example, whenever I record some reels, either for Instagram or TikTok or shorts, I upload them in here. And then what I do is I also take that transcript and I put it into ChatGPT to give me any type of caption or a way that I can expand it into a blog post if I want. Like, I really love using Riverside for easy transcriptions. They make it so much easier. So I love the remote recording studio, and I also love the transcriptions feature. It makes my process for YouTube, for publishing out these YouTube videos, a lot easier than me doing what I used to do manually. Having these other additional like magic clips or these other features makes my other content creation a lot easier as well. Let me know in the comments, what do you think about Riverside right now? Are you going to give it a shot? Hopefully you understood why some of these features inside of Riverside were my personal favorites. And I hope that it has inspired you to see how you can start using Riverside in your own business. Again, if you want to take a peek around, go ahead and click the link in the video description. And if you want to use my code Jamar Diggs, you're going to get 15% off of your purchase. Now that you have the tools that you need to be successful on YouTube, do you have the strategy? Now that's the question. If you don't, I have a whole free training that is going to walk you through my signature process of how I'm able to get clients results for their business. It's called the YouTube Funnel Blueprint, and the link to that is going to be down below. If you like this video, please let me know by subscribing to this channel, giving this video a like, and also follow me up on Instagram at Jamar Diggs and tag me and let me know that you have watched this video and that you are getting started on creating the most amazing YouTube channel in the world. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.